Today, the Mushtaraka Mahalli Samal have met under the leadership of presidentship of Maulana Abdul Rahim Qureshi Sahab. And it was decided that first of all, we condemned the killing of the four police people by the terrorists in Suryapet. There is no justification whatsoever for killing of those four brave police personnel who died in the line of duty. All of us pay homage to the great sacrifice they have given in neutralizing those two wanted people who were wanted by different states. Secondly, today it was decided that we also condemn the killings of 20 people in the Andhra Pradesh state. That killing also has no justification. Those people, if they were smugglers, they should have been apprehended. They should have been arrested. Thirdly, the main focus was today on the encounter which took place yesterday of those five under-trial prisoners who were facing grievous charges. And the committee felt, the Mushtaraka Mahalli Samal is of the opinion, after having heard the lawyer Mr. Azim, Abdul Azim, that the two criminal cases were at closing stages, and within another month the case would have been closed and the judgment would have come. And also one of the accused had written a letter, his father has written a letter to the Chief Justice and to the Human Rights that he fears threat to his life. In writing this was given. And the second point which Mr. Abdul Azim have brought to our notice is that on 6th of April, that is on Monday, one of the accused have given a letter to the Honorable Judge asking him to be transferred to Hyderabad, either Challapalli Jail or Chinchalguda. So the public prosecutor had said that he will file a counter, that is today. It is a known fact that in the then Andhra Pradesh state, many such stage managed encounter killings have taken place. This is also a stage managed, as rightly said by Maulana Abdul Rahim Qureshi, that this is a cold-blooded murder of five under trials. India as a country has shown to the whole world, when Mumbai attack took place in 2611, one dreaded terrorist who was responsible for killing hundreds of Indians, Ajmal Kasab, was caught. But as a country, we showed to the whole world that Ajmal Kasab would get a fair trial. Ajmal Kasab got a fair trial. Our courts of law gave him a fair trial as an accused. He was given an opportunity to appeal. His conviction was upheld. The whole world noticed that how India as a country, despite facing murder and mayhem in Mumbai for 2 days, we have given that dreaded person who every one of us hates. My question now is, yes, those boys were facing grave criminal charges. The courts were about to give in a month judgment on that case. And we would like to know from the government that what is the opinion of the government? What is the opinion of this government? Because we have unconditionally condemned then and now the killings of the four policemen who have laid down their lives against this terrorist, fighting this terrorist. Will the government order a CBI inquiry, which we are demanding, or an inquiry by a sitting High Court judge? We want the truth to come out. Because if you allow these extrajudicial killings, this will lead to anarchy and mayhem in our society. If people at large close their eyes to such killings, that saying that no, they were facing grievous charges, then we don't require courts. We don't require civil procedure at all, or criminal procedure. The police cannot be allowed to become judge and jury. For rule of law to prevail, we demand from this government that a CBI inquiry should be ordered. If they are not agreeable to CBI inquiry, let a sitting High Court judge do an inquiry. I tell you why, because with the permission of our president, you must remember that in 2008, after Makkah Masjid bomb blast, police firing took place. A retired High Court judge was appointed. The president, in his capacity as a lawyer, went there and argued in front of that retired judge that police firing which took place after Makkah Masjid bomb blast was wrong, uncalled for. That report is still yet to see the light of the day. This is how the governments buy time, so that we forget. We don't forget. We still remember those people who died in the police firing on the streets of Shalibanda. Let me also remind you that in the month of June or July, in Arsh Mahal in Kishanbagh, two people were killed in police firing. What has happened to that inquiry, we don't know. Now we are seeing this. So it is in the interest of justice, in the interest to uphold the rule of law. It is the demand of each and every one, of every right-thinking person living in society, that an independent inquiry must be ordered to know the true facts. And we would like to know that yes, the police fraternity must be very angry. They must be having tears in their eyes. We sympathize with you. We are with you. We salute your sacrifice of those four police officers. But what is this? That will your tears be wiped out if these five people are bumped off? People will always remember the great sacrifice of those four police people. But what about this killing? When the trial was at the very last stages. So that is why this committee has decided that under the presidentship of Maulana Abdul Rahim Qureshi, we would meet the Honorable Chief Minister, put forward our demands to him. We will also meet the Honorable Governor, and we will see what the response of the government would be. We would like to know what the Governor in his capacity will do. Because we will not only be making a representation for yesterday's encounter, but also for that encounter which took place in Andhra Pradesh. Because the Governor is a Governor of both the states. And that is why this is what has been decided. And we have asked for the timing from the Chief Minister's office. As soon we hope that we get the time as quickly as possible, and we'll go and meet the Chief Minister. And after making this representation, all avenues are open. Democratic avenues are open, and this is what I like to say. And just to brief you, the names of the esteemed people who have come to this meeting is Maulana Akbar Nizamuddin Sahib, Jafar Pasha Sahib, Nayyar Sahab, Safi Madni Sahab, Ulfa Shutari Sahab, सॉरी सज्जाद पाशा साहब, रहीमुद्दीन अंसारी साहब, हमारे आगा साहब एंड खादरी साहब एंड दिस इज व्हाट एंड मुर्तजा पाशा खादरी साहब, दिस हैज बीन डिसाइडेड टुडे. थैंक यू. हम उनके गम को समझ सकते बट हम आज जो डिसाइड करें आपके सामने रखें. मैंने समझता कि बीसी कमीशन की हियरिंग ज्यादा हो जाएगा, स्ट्रेच करे ऐसा होता. वो नेशनल बीसी कमीशन है, स्टेट बीसी कमीशन का नहीं होगा. That is why Umar Farooq Saab, we are asking for an independent inquiry. And only an independent inquiry will establish all the facts. But on the face of it, it looks a stage managed cold-blooded killing. And whether we are right or wrong, in the interest of justice, an independent inquiry is required. No. It is a revenge killing, isn't it? Because that boy was charged for a grievous offense, as explained by Abdul Azim Sahab. The trial is at its very last stages. The judgment would have come very soon.
Sir, one supplement. Why I'm asking this question of political angle? As you mentioned, we have a long record of police atrocities of this nature in Andhra Pradesh history. And whenever such thing happens, politically the government of the time has to pay a price. Do you think this government is going to pay a price?
Umar Farooq Saab, when I use this word in the interest of justice, in the interest of justice, inquiry has to be done. And it all depends on what the government does. If the government is interested to ensure that justice should be done, which is their constitutional duty, that is why we have separation of powers. That is why we have a right to free trial. And that is why in a democracy, the people will go out and exercise their right to vote for anyone. How explicit do you want me to be?
सर क्या ये सच है कि जब भी वारंगल से लोग को कोर्ट को लाया जा रहा था, अब तक दो तीन अपना अटैक करने की कोशिश की
है? वही बात अब्दुल अजीम साहब बता चुके हैं कि उसमें से जो एक्यूज्ड है उन्हें एक लेटर लिखे उनके वालिद विजय ह्यूमन राइट्स छह महीने पहले लिख के विजय के मेरे खतरा है. और कोर्ट में पीर के दिन 6 तारीख के दिन वो कोर्ट से लिख के दिए कि मेरा ट्रांसफर करो क्योंकि 2 साल से वारंगल में है. वो दूसरे 2 साल से वारंगल में है तो पीपी ने कहा कि हम काउंटर फाइल करेंगे. थैंक यू. बस थैंक यू सर. शुक्रिया सर. थैंक यू.